So hello everyone, this is Rob Kelly, creator of the Thrive Programme, and this is the very lovely Mary. Mary's now 84, and 3 years ago, Mary went through the Thrive Programme to learn how to thrive, but also to overcome a huge fear of being sick known as emetophobia. So I'm checking with Mary now, 3 years down the line, and if it's all right, Mary, I'd just like to ask a few questions.
Yeah, sure.
Try not to look quite so frightened. So, Mary, tell us about your emetophobia. Do you still have emetophobia in any way, shape or form?
No, I don't have it in any shape or form. I just live a life. I still don't like the idea of being sick, but I just don't think about it anymore. And I know that if I was, I'd cope with it. But it's a freedom that I didn't have for 75 years. A complete freedom from a mind full of, do I feel sick? Was that a bit sick on the ground? Is my friend going to be sick? I was just overcome all the time. And if I was going out for a meal, I wouldn't enjoy the meal. I usually wouldn't eat it because I'd think it might make me sick. But I'm afraid, or not afraid, that's a silly thing to say, but for 3 years now, thanks to Rob and Thrive, I go out and about, I enjoy myself, and my mind is full of more interesting things.
Do you ever, Mary, do you, because people, emetophobes that are watching this will think, oh yeah, well, you know, she probably still has the thoughts, but is good at batting them away. Do you have any scary thoughts on a daily basis about being sick?
No, not on a daily basis at all.
Not at all?
No.
It's not that you've just got really good at fighting these thoughts off.
No.
You simply don't have them anymore.
They just don't appear. They've gone.
What do you think, Mary, was the turning point for you? If you had to name one thing going through the program, one belief or something that you think made all the difference to you, what was that?
It was this thought that, however much I don't like the idea of vomiting, the thought that I could cope with it. I'd never thought of that before. I just always thought I must not be sick whatever happens. I just suddenly got this idea that I still wouldn't like it, but I knew that I would cope with it. And really, that was the beginning of it all, Rob.
Because of it, so if there's something that one cannot cope with, then understandably you have to avoid it on pain of death.
Exactly.
Yeah? Yeah. But when you reduced it from I couldn't cope at all to actually it wouldn't be very nice, but I'd be all right. I could cope.
Yeah.
That was I remember you at the time. That was the big change. In terms of your thriving life now, tell us about your thriving life now. I know at the moment, I'm sorry to hear that your cancer's back, but without being rude, you don't seem to be affected by that very much.
Funnily enough, cancer doesn't worry me.
Cancer doesn't worry you?
No. I've had it twice before. It's not the old ones. This is a totally different one. I've got over it twice before, and I firmly believe, especially if I'm thriving, which means I'm having a happy life, not too much stress, I think I'll overcome the cancer. So it's not a big problem to me.
You mentioned to me last time I saw you that you're waiting till you're 100 until you get your birthday card from the Queen. Is that something you still think about?
I do still think about that, right? Because it was a promise I made to myself when I had a ovarian cancer back in 1981. And having made that promise at that time, it was a place I went to that believed in helping you to overcome your cancer. Now, the only problem is the Queen will be dead. If I'm lucky, it might be King William
who
sends me a card. But that doesn't mean I've necessarily got to die when I'm 100.
All right.
I know that I can live to 100 at least.
Okay, good to hear. What about, Mary, what about people out there that think, obviously hers wasn't that bad, you know, mine's really bad, my emetophobia, hers can't have been that bad. What would you say to them?
Well, if I tell you that, one, I trained as a junior school teacher, and I loved the job. I certainly loved the kids. But because kids would come up and say, "Please, miss, I feel sick," and then proceed to be sick, after 1 year of teaching, that's my whole career that I'd hoped to have, I just had to give it up. When I had my first cancer, they wanted me to have chemotherapy, and in those days, chemotherapy meant every time you had it, you'd be sick for about 3 days, and I refused it. And I was more or less told, if you don't have chemotherapy, you'll die. Well, at that time, I'd have sooner died. So just the fact that I gave up a career that I loved, that I would rather accept death than being sick, do I need to say any more about how strong it was?
How do you feel looking back at that person now, when you're so full of life? How does that feel, looking back at that person, that you're thinking you'd rather have died?
I feel like, how sad, because to me, I've wasted a lot of my life unnecessarily. However, in my earlier days, there was nothing like Thrive around, and the sort of treatment, I did get some medical treatment, but it was no help. But I think now that Thrive is there, if you really, what you do have to work at it, you do have to do it. It's no good thinking, oh, he won't know, I don't have to do this bit. If you really do everything that the book says, I think you are bound to end up thriving and enjoy your life. If you've got emetophobia, and if you want to start enjoying your life, then getting rid of that emetophobia should be virtually the top on any list of what you're going to do. It comes first, not somewhere down the pile because you're busy. Just think, when you achieve it, you'll realise how worthwhile it was.
And one final thing, Mary, thank you. How different, not just in relation to emetophobia, but how different are you? How different is your feelings, your attitude towards life now compared to what it was 4 years ago when you had severe emeto?
It's totally different. I mean, even things like, I've got quite a bit of arthritis, most old people have, and I find if I'm going out, instead of like in the old days, I'd be saying, oh, this awful pain, I wish I hadn't got to go to the shops. I literally think differently, and I pull myself up straight and I think, I'm going to walk as though I'm going out hiking with some friends, and I start swinging my arms, and to be honest, within 5 or 10 minutes I've forgotten all about the arthritis. It's just, in the end, it's a totally different way of thinking about everything. So if it's pouring with rain and I'm just looking out my window, and it is, and I've recently got interested in gardening. So now I think, well, the rain's not much fun to go out in, but it's doing a lot of good to my garden. It's wonderful that we get a bit of rain. And I've even seen spiders, that I was terrified of spiders. And they can just walk across the room now and I just totally ignore them. And it's hard to explain. But it's as though your whole life you've been bogged down and something has come along and removed it all, and suddenly you're light and airy and you're free and life is fun. And in fact, I realise nowadays life is beautiful. I love looking at the sunset, sunrise, and I think, God, what a wonderful world. Never mind all the horrible news, the beauty out there. So again, look for the beauty in life, not keep looking at the bad things. You must, it's something you have to do if you've got emetophobia, is to yourself make the effort, get rid of it. Don't walk about on crutches for the rest of your life and in pain. Chuck them all away, please.
Mary, thank you very, very much. And hopefully, sweetheart, what I'll do, if I'm still alive in 16 years when you get your 100th birthday card from King William, we'll come and do another video.
Yeah, I'd love to do that.
All right, thank you very much.